Hello, and thank you for joining me today to discuss the Accountability Calculator. I am Ben Riley, the Systems IT Consultant in the Division of Assessment and Accountability Support in the Office of Assessment and Accountability. The Data Calculator or Accountability Calculator will be delivered to you in the secure web apps as a Microsoft Excel spreadsheet. The spreadsheet will be included in the data release for QC Day. It will be located under the student data detail in the district zip file under a folder called Calculator. One purpose of this calculator is to provide a resource that can help district assessment coordinators and other education leaders by creating possible scenarios. The calculator allows you to place different student numbers into the spreadsheet and observe the impact those changes will have on the scores. If you look along the bottom of the spreadsheet, there are three tabs. The first tab is called the Information tab, and this contains information and directions about using the Accountability Calculator tool. Please refer back to this tab for questions you may have about the intent and purpose of this tool. The second tab contains English Learner Progress growth value tables for standard and alternate assessments. The third tab is called the Data Entry tab, and it will be pre-populated with your school's accountability data. In this tab, you may change student counts to create hypothetical scenarios. For the purpose of this video, we have generated mock-up data to demonstrate and discuss tips for using the calculator tool to better understand the student data for your district. Now that we're in this Data Entry tab, let's demonstrate how to use it. When using the calculator, the first step is to select the appropriate level, elementary, middle, or high. So I'm going to go ahead and we're going to stay on elementary for this. To make it easy to use and understand, the data entry is restricted to the yellow boxes only on this tab. If you're trying to create a scenario where a new school is opening, use the applicable blank choice in the drop-down menu. Let me show that to you. This will enable you to begin without any numbers and create hypothetical data scenarios. Let's go ahead, as we're jumping into this tab, and look at some of the things we see. The first thing you'll notice is that you see numbers appearing in red. The numbers appearing in red are the original calculations for the chosen school or district as a whole. These remain the same to allow for quick comparison while working through the scenario. You first notice the overall accountability table with the blue headers. This table contains the indicator scores, weights applied to each indicator, the index score for each indicator, and the overall performance score that determines the school's color rating. If data are not available for the indicator, you'll notice the weights proportionally redistributed to the remaining indicators. You will also notice blacked out cells. Blacked out cells are not applicable to the chosen school or level. No data entry is allowed in these cells. A great example of this would be post-secondary readiness and graduate rate when looking at elementary level data. Under the overall accountability table, there is a table with green headers, and that includes a breakdown of the number of students in each performance level across content areas and scores for each content area. Under the content assessments table, you'll see another table that includes the breakdown of the number of students in each range of English learner performance on the English Language Proficiency exam. To the right, you will see the tables for scores from the QSCS survey, constructs and numbers of students distributing to the post-secondary readiness and graduation rate indicators. Finally, in the upper left-hand corner, there are two very important buttons to click. The first is the Clear Data button, and the second is the Restore Data button. The Clear Data button will do as it says and clear all the data from the tables in front of you. The Restore Data button will restore your data to the original tables before being modified. I like to think of this one as a reset button. So now that we've looked at the basic structure of the spreadsheet, let's look at a few scenarios now that we have our data. Let's create a comparative scenario to see what would happen to our scores if we moved 10 students from novice to apprentice in all content areas. So I'm going to go over to the cells and we're going to just simply take away 10 from the top. And now we're going to add 10 into the apprentice. There we go. After inputting the new data into this content area, we can see how this impacts the overall index score for that content area and could also impact numbers in the associated indicator cells in the overall accountability score in the accountability table. For this change in particular, we can see that moving 10 students into each content area from novice to apprentice impacted each content area index score in the content assessments table and also changed the overall accountability score in the accountability table from 49 to 50.6. Next, I'd like to see the impact of having more English learner growth on my accountability scores. I'm going to move a few EL students to a different performance range to see what possible impact they could have on my overall table. Let's do that now. Okay, after I have input the data change, I can see in the accountability table that has increased the EL indicator score from 60 to 62.8, which impacted my overall accountability score from 49.0 to 49.1. Now I'd like to see how increasing my graduation rate impacts the overall score. I'm going to go to the high school data mockup as I'm currently working in the elementary mockup. So I'm going to go to the drop down tab here and click KY mockup district high. I'm going to increase the 4 and 5 year graduation numbers to create this hypothetical scenario. Looking back at the overall table now that we've made that increase, I can see that it increased my graduation indicator from 94.3 to 99.0. And it also increased my overall accountability score from 47.3 to 47.6. The purpose of this tool is to enable DAX to easily create different hypothetical scenarios to better understand your district's data and to set instructional goals for your district or school. For more information or explanations of the accountability system, please visit our meetings and trainings webpage. If you have any questions concerning your data specifically, please reach out to us at KDE Assessment, all one word, at education.ky.gov. Thank you and have a wonderful day.